这个木炭啊，一个是还原剂，一个是氧化剂，这样结合起来才能够燃烧嘛。我们火药的成分是一硝、二磺、三木炭，必须要木炭它才能够燃烧。如果单一用火焰去熏它，它永远不会燃的，就是它的硝酸钾融化了，它也不会燃烧起来。
Potassium nitrate is high tensile and a powerful coagulant. Its use as a building material has been a key factor in the Taoping ancient Chang village's survival of 2,000 years of earthquakes. The Chang people long ago became experienced in mitigating the effects of earthquakes. The techniques they developed are an intangible cultural heritage, which they incorporated into the construction of the ancient village.
The 墙四周形成四道板块，这么高的地方，基础还有两米多深，形成四道板块，这样多的圈梁，这样好的基础，一般的建筑是办不到的。所以它能够千年不倒，它能够抗住地震。
In the wall, the pieces of rubble fit one another naturally. Evidently, there's nothing random about this arrangement. The builders first select good quality rubble and hammer the irregular pieces to get rid of any fragments. Then they put various pieces into place, adjusting their positions constantly so as to maximize the cohesion between rubble and loess. The adjustment can be repeated anything up to 50 times.
陶坪羌寨，它的建筑的这个工艺非常的高超。工匠在一不拉直线、二不掉垂线这种情况下去琢的，它这个每一个石头啊，它的犬牙交错啊。结构是非常的好。
Experienced engineers make precise calculations concerning the bases of the walls and the walls themselves. Every piece of rubble and every handful of loess was carefully placed, the first layer lengthways and the second sideways, so as to maximize the cohesion. Both sides of the walls had to be properly arranged.Centered on large stones in the middle. To increase the shock resistance of the walls, the Chang craftsmen made them all slightly concave. They also formed a corner on every wall known as the wall stud, or Changlengzhe in the Chang language. Wall studs placed at the edge of the houses would bear the full force of any earthquakes and would allow the Chang houses to withstand both transverse and vertical shocks. It was the practice, after each story of a building was completed, for nothing to be built on top for at least a year. The Chang people did this to allow the rubble and loess to settle and bond more strongly.A wall would be deemed sufficiently stable only if it could withstand the climate changes and rainstorms of a whole year without losing any of its loess. So it took 3 years to build a three-story Chang building and 13 years to build a 13-story building. The rubble and loess walls built over 2,000 years ago may look delicate, but they are in fact extremely solid.
墙的这个四个面啊，都不是垂直的，它是斜的，大概有2至5度的倾斜度，所以呢，每一个面它都是一个等腰梯形，上小下大的等腰梯形啊，这样的话就是说，无论地震波从哪个方向过来，它整个楼体。成一个圆锥体，它在这样抖动的时候，无论多么大的地震，它的点部的重锤线不会超过它的基础的。
To improve their resistance to earthquakes, Chang houses were built in a pyramidal structure characterized by a wide bottom and a narrow top. The walls in the bottom layer are 60 centimeters wide, and those in the top layer 20 to 30 centimeters wide. The entire wall leans inwards towards the middle. In a five-story building, there could be a horizontal difference exceeding 20 centimeters between the top and the bottom of the walls. The walls, being solidly built and symmetrical, are capable of withstanding a force from any direction. Besides the solid walls, Chang buildings incorporate other supplementary supports. Three wooden pillars form a system that supports the floors and the roof. Chang buildings are usually quite low. Those used for living and working tend to have just three stories. The inner structure adopts the space-cutting technique, combining stone walls and beams. The layers of wall are separated every jiang by beams 20 centimeters in diameter, with rafters above them. A smooth groove was cut in the top of the wooden pillar on the first floor and another in the corresponding part on the bottom of the wooden pillar for the second floor. The main beam would be inserted between them. Sometimes a supplementary beam might be added parallel with the main beam. This was in fact a primitive form of a bucket arch, which could disperse the pressure from the junction of the wooden pillars and beams so as to strengthen the beams. The interweaving of the beams and stone walls, combined with the joining of the beams of wooden pillars, effectively reinforced the whole structure and increased its capacity to withstand shocks. Seen from above, the ancient Chang village is revealed as a collection of buildings all forming a complete architectural complex.
It's become a whole. 我们知道在这个居住碉楼的时候，它是螺旋形这样上升的，这样的话它的这个结构是非常的好，它整体性非常的强。The
various houses are linked to one another in an integrated whole. The buildings and alleys, by being connected, can better withstand earthquakes. Compared with the interconnected ancient Chang houses, later Chang buildings are more independent in order to accommodate tourists. However, being independent makes the buildings more vulnerable to earthquakes. The ancient Chang people acquired their architectural genius by studying nature. Having migrated from far away, they have now been living in this place for many generations. To visit Taoping ancient Chang village is like traveling back through the long history of the Chang people. It was raining on July the 15th, 2008. The Chang people, still getting over the shock and devastation of the Wenchuan earthquake, were gathering beside the village entrance, dressed in their finest. What were they waiting for? I hereby launch the project to save and protect the watchtowers and villages of the Chang nationality. With these words from Xia Jixiang, director of the State Administration of Cultural Heritage, the Chang started to sing and dance, celebrating the preservation of their unique heritage.
这个5.12汶川大地震以来呢，我们就是迅速行动呢，对整个地震灾区的文化遗产受损情况进行了评估。那么地震这个发生以后呢，在一个星期内呢，我们的文物保护的这个集中全国的各地的这个文物保护的专业人员，就深入到灾区的各个这个文物保护单位来进行评估。两个星期以后呢，我们的评估报告就是基本完成了，在这基础上又编制了预算的报告和呢这个工程抢险修缮的总体规划，特别是要在不改变文物原状的文物保护法所确定的原则和呢文物保护具体的文物建筑原这个原地位置、原形式、原结构、原工艺、原材料这样一些基本原则的前提下呢，来使呢这个修复后的这些文物保护单位呢，这个抗震性能更强，他们呢这个周围的他们的环境更好，这是我们修缮这次的工作的目标。
Guided by such principles, the Chang village is promised an even better appearance in the future. Today, Taoping Ancient Chang Village is much more than a remarkable collection of buildings. In a sense, the Chang houses and watchtowers have assumed a historical mission: to keep alive a unique architectural culture. Architecture, in its highest form, incorporates into buildings mankind's respect for life and lays a solid foundation for the survival of human beings in their rapidly changing environment.